Maya Govanen, and welcome! Today, we're gonna explore the daily routine of the elves from the Legendarium, or rather, how you can describe your daily routine in Sindarin Elvish. So, let's say that you're studying abroad in the home of the Sindar elves. It's a very particular exchange program, let's just say. And today, your task is to describe your daily routine, daily life there. So firstly, how can you say daily life in Elvish? Well, from what I found, the word for life is quill, and the adjective daily is translated as ilaurui. So from that, we can create the phrase daily life, ilaurui quill. So how do you start your day? Well, probably by waking up. But with all the jet lag and so on, someone else would probably have to wake you up. So, wake up in Sindarin is ekuyo. As it is just one word, it can be translated more accurately as awaken. Then, when you're finally awake...
Hey, you! You're finally awake!
You need some motivation to get through the day. You can whisper to yourself, Gwaem, let's go. Now, we're most probably getting to the realm of Neo-Sindarin here, but I hope you don't mind. And suddenly, you hear a noise coming from the kitchen downstairs. Turns out, your host family calls you for breakfast. Tolo, mado, they say. They don't even have to raise their voice, because the sound is echoing through those perfectly designed walls. Breakfast, shopping, studying, the whole day you hang out with your Elvish family. So let's see how you can address different members of the family and how they can address you, the younger one. No matter how old you are, you're probably gonna be the youngest there. So firstly, the word for family is nos. And then, inside the family, depending on who you are and your relation with the other person, you're gonna have to use different expressions. So let's go through them right now. An older elf may say to you, Henik, my child. Now, don't you dare use this phrase to other people or elves around your age, as it implies a diminutive meaning. But older elves can also use more specific expressions towards you. My son, or my daughter, and those would respectively translate to Jonek and Jelik. And if you're close with your host parents, like really close, you could address them by saying Daddy and Mommy, which are Ada and Nana. Although these two are probably the easiest words to remember in Elvish, as they are so similar to other languages, like Spanish, I mostly mention them here just for reference. Don't go out swinging them around. Wait, can you swing words around? And of course, eating together is a time for conversations. However, with all the chewing going on, you can mishear or misunderstand somebody. In that case, you can ask them to repeat by saying Mang Pengnik? What did you say? Now, after the meal, and oh man, I'd love to try some elven food someday. Well, you should of course thank the host family. We've already covered many thank yous in other episodes, but here's a sentence you can use specifically while eating. Maer es hen, meaning this food is delicious. Now that's easy and effective. You may even feel so grateful that you feel the need to say, I love you. I don't know why I'm not mentioning this phrase more often. It's so beautiful. It goes like this. Gimelin. This is in the informal form, so make sure you're on good terms with your host family first. I also feel like the sentence is pretty easy to memorize, so I really encourage you to do so. This one is super important. So then, after breakfast, you're probably going to school or work. While I couldn't find those words in a native Sindarin dictionary, I discovered this. Mirian. It is the name for currency used in the land of Gondor, and also in the game Shadow of War. Actually, it turns out that Sauron tried to destroy that coin in the Second Age. But currencies in the land of Middle-earth are kind of a sensitive topic in that it's not very clear, so I leave it at that. I of course encourage you to explore different resources, some of which, as always, I'll put in the description. And, you know, during various daily activities, you may find yourself in a bit of a rush. So here are a couple of phrases to use during those stressful moments. For example, if you want to urge someone to move quicker, just shout "Noro," "Run." Surprisingly, the expression "stop" in Sindarin is very similar. It is "daro." I hope you can see the grammatical structure here. But why may someone ask you to stop? Well, of course, there are many reasons, but one of them is that the way you're going may be shut. So I found exactly this phrase in Sindarin. "This way is shut" is "holen I ven." And after a stressful day, I'd love to take a stroll under the night sky in Mirkwood, for example, the home of Legolas. In Sindarin, you can describe this activity as "padet nguin giliath." It means walking under the stars. Just wanted to throw it in here, but it really would be nice, wouldn't it? Okay, that's pretty much your whole day. After you come back home, which in Sindarin is called bar, pretty ironic, isn't it? You can go lay in your bed. Yeah, I'll tell you how it is in Sindarin. It's housed. Then your host mother comes to your room. She's a very nice lady, elf lady, of course. Every night she says to you, "sweet dreams," or literally, "dream well." Olove. Damn, that's nice. You can respond with a similar phrase. "Rest well" in Sindarin is postove. I think you can see the word for well repeating. Hopefully it can make it easier to memorize for you. Those are real nice sentences. Okay, sleep time. Remember to get at least 8 hours. Tomorrow you're doing all of that all over again, but without me narrating it all. So I hope it's gonna be an enjoyable day for you, truly. But we'll meet again. So until then, Nalu e Govanedvin.